Hello, and welcome to part 2 of the video. Today we are going to be attaching our knotted thread into our design. I based it on a bedspread made by Mrs. Delany, held at the Ulster Museum in Belfast. So grab your knotted thread and let's start. The materials are very simple. You will need your design drawn on fabric and hooped, as well as embroidery scissors, regular sewing thread on a needle, We want to do a double thread, knotted in the end. We start by attaching the Riego's knot. I will start with from the inside of the design. I will do a double stitch right at the beginning to secure it properly. And we'll start attaching the cord between each knot. Sometimes the thread catches on the knots, so it's best to go slow. We continue following the line that's drawn. Since there's a lot of curves, I found that making a stitch between every knot was easier to follow the design. When we come towards the end of the design, we simply snip the last knot and we cut it to size and we do a double stitch to secure it in place, sort of hiding the beginning on top of the last stitch. And I'm securing the thread in the back, simply whipping it on the couching stitches and doing a simple knot. We do the same thing with the double-sided knots. Again, securing the beginning of the work with 2 stitches, and on this one I believe I skipped 1 knot, so I think I did every other knot, especially in the bits that were a little bit less curvier, and we simply take care that we're following the line of the design properly. Thank you. going as we did before, and you see that it actually doesn't take very long. It's something that works up to be quite quickly. The knots may be a little bit slow to make, but attaching them is much faster than perhaps doing French knots or single knots of embroidery. Coming to an end, we simply snip to size, and I believe on this one I folded the last little knot under to make it neat. And we secure with stitches. Back again, I whip back through the stitches that I've done before to secure everything in place with the knot. And finished. You can press your work to finish it off face down on a towel and iron it that way as to not to lose the texture. In the description you can find a link to a version of the motif as well as a teapot cover that I made inspired by it. You can make it with any materials you like. I encourage you to give it a try. Don't hesitate to leave your comments down below, and if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and click on the bell. I would love to see your own versions of it, so please tag me on Instagram at Antique Needlework so that I can see it. You can follow me there. I share some of my personal projects as well as information that I find during my research. See you next time!